Now, in verse 6, we come to the second division here, and we have an initiation into the ways of God. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he's near. Now, the way of God and the way of man are put in contrast and conflict. And the objection is often made that this is not a legitimate gospel call for today, as man is not asked to seek God, but on the contrary, God's seeking man. Well, I will buy that. It's accurate. But the call today, and from the human aspect, human responsibility is not defeated by the sovereign purposes and election of God. And therefore, the Lord Jesus could say, all the Father giveth me, they'll come to me. And he that cometh to me, I'll in no wise cast out. They'll come. You can sit on the sidelines and argue all you want to that you're not elect. But my friend, the minute that you come, you're elect. And that's up to you. And he says now, let the wicked forsake his way. The unrighteous man his thoughts. Let him return unto the Lord, and he'll have mercy upon him to our God, for he'll abundantly pardon. The problem today with man is not mental. You hear people say, oh, I have great questions and hurdles to get over. No, you don't. Well, you'd have one. That's sin in your life that you don't want to give up. That's the one thing that keeps men from God. Let the wicked forsake his way. And when you do, friend, you're just ready to turn to him. That's when you get really thirsty. Now God says, my thoughts are not your thoughts. My ways are not your way. He says, the heavens are high above the earth. And the gospel is not a man-made thing. It's come down from heaven. It's God's gospel. Now, in the third thing here, beginning with verse 10, we have here the third last division, and this is the institution of the Word of God. Now, when the gospel is given out, the emphasis is put upon the accuracy of the Word of God and upon the reliability of it and the importance of it. Listen to this. For as the rain cometh down and the snow from heaven and returneth not thither, but watereth the earth and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it. Now, in this closing section, there is a prominence given to the Word of God. That's the only place that the gospel is found, is in the Word of God. Salvation is a revelation of God, and the Word of God now is likened unto rain, comes down from heaven. You see, friends, the gospel is not God asking you to do something, and the gospel is not something that man thinks up. Man does not work his way up to God by some Tower of Babel effort. But he receives God's revelation, which comes down from heaven like rain. And just as the rain comes down. And when I made this tape, we have had a delightful rain here in Southern California. And we hadn't had rain in a long time. How wonderful it was. The rain will cause the earth to become fruitful. And the Word of God's call also the seed, you see. And when the rain and the seed get together in the earth, down here, in the human heart, then something's going to happen. And he says here, for ye shall go out with joy and be led forth with peace. The mountains and the hills shall break before you into singing, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands. You see, the rain causes the earth to respond with a green blanket of praise to God. And someday the earth will respond with a note of praise to the Creator and the Redeemer, because we're told creation's groaning and travailing in pain until now. And then he says, instead of the thorn shall come up the fir tree, instead of the briar shall come up the myrtle tree, and it shall be to the Lord for a name, for an everlasting sign that shall not be cut off. You see, this looks forward to the millennium, when the earth will be redeemed and the curse of sin removed. Because you see, when Christ died, he not only redeemed us as sinners, but a sin-cursed